Hello everyone, welcome back to our Farming RPG tutorial series. While testing the farm scene, I realized that if you stay long enough, you will notice that there is some unusual NPC behavior going on. Jeff appears in the distance and walks towards you before he disappears. This is due to some accidental NPC placement in the scene. So to fix this, we just have to delete him in the farm scene and he's gone. And with that, we can get to what we mainly want to do today, which is implementing the food system. I found this very useful asset pack by Kenny that happened to have everything that we need. It even comes with PNG previews of each food item, which we can use for the item icons. So I imported the preview and FBXs over in our imported assets folder. Now on to the implementation. We created a food data scriptable object that inherits from item data to handle consumption effects. For now, all we are going to do is restore stamina when food is consumed. Over in player stats, we set up a function to handle stamina increases. When players consume food items, it will restore their stamina up to a maximum of 150. We probably would be making this a variable sometime later, such that the player can increase their max stamina, but for now, this will do. Now to have the player eat the food. Head over to the player interaction script on item interact. We'll make the player eat the item he is holding, if he is holding a consumable item. And with that, we created some food items in the resources/items folder. We added several new food items, including soup, french fries, rice balls, sandwiches, coffee, and wine. And as you can see, after a long day of working the fields, the player is able to restore his stamina by eating some rice balls. Next, we'll build the inn where the player can socialize with NPCs and actually buy some of this stuff. First, we'll set up the basic scene layout with tables, chairs, and some atmospheric props. We're adding navigation points for NPCs to move around naturally. The inn connects to the town map, so we'll need to set the scene transition points as well. Now this is what I really want to do today. The real reason why we implemented the food system is because I want to use it to introduce a marriage candidate in the game, with a totally original backstory that is not influenced by my favorite character in Friends of Mineral Town or anything like that. Yeah. Okay, anyway, so let's create our innkeeper character, Frank. For now, let's set him up such that he spends his day in the inn, and he runs the shop that sells food and drinks to the players. After we set up his character, the shop items and everything, I realized that the buying system was broken because of our TextMesh Pro switch that we did a while back. So I reassigned the prompts in the Essentials prefab. And I also realized that the NavMesh was broken for some scenes, so I rebaked them as well as the in scene. Now on to our first marriage candidate. Let's name her Abby. Set up her basic character data and positions within the town, inn, and forest, along with some dialogue. For now, we set it up such that she spends her mornings foraging in the forest before walking to the town to hang around for a bit, before going to the inn to start work. And after testing, I realized that time stops after Abby is in town at around 8 AM. Looks like the error is coming from GetExit Position in Location Manager. So I added some exception handling that we can get a better understanding of the problem. And I realized I forgot to update the scene connections after adding the in scene. So with that, we have to update that. And while we were at it, I decided to get rid of the pesky controller error that keeps popping up by adding an additional check in player controller. Next, I touched up on the character dialogues in this schedule, adding time-based dialogues for different times and places of the day. I thought it would be cool to have Frank talk about his artifact collecting hobby when he's not running the shop. And I made Jeff and Ben visit the inn after working hours as well. And as you can see, the lighting needs some work, especially when it comes to nighttime and in the early mornings. And Abby just disappears into the shadows of the forest. So we touched up on it a little, with buildings being clearly visible in the dark, with some places lit. We also did up the portraits of the NPCs, and that's it for this part. Hope you enjoyed it. If you would like to download the project files for this series, it is available for our Silver tier patrons. We once again thank you all for your support, and we will see you next time.